Shalom, welcome to Bible Learner's Corner. We're going to start a discussion talking about eternity. Eternity, what is eternity? The book of Psalms 93 talks about the Lord reigning. The Lord reigns, starting from verse 1. The Lord reigns, He is robed in majesty. The Lord is robed in majesty and armed with strength. Indeed, the world is established, firm and secure. Your throne was established long ago. You are from all eternity. The seas have lifted up, Lord. The seas have lifted up their voice. The seas have lifted up their pounding waves. The book of Psalms, chapter 93, verses 1 to 3, talking about the Lord reigning from eternity. He established His world within eternity before He stretched forth earth from the heavens. The Lord had a plan, and His plan is from eternity to eternity. The book of the Ecclesiastes, chapter 3, from verses 10 to 12, talks about the heart of mankind. The preacher says, I have seen the burden God has laid on the human race. He has made everything beautiful in its time. He has set eternity in the human heart. Yet no one can fathom what God has done from beginning to end. The preacher continued to say, I know that there is nothing better for people than to be happy and to do good while they live. This life under the heavens, the light under the sun, has a beginning. It has an end. It is life within eternity. Eternity has got no beginning, it has no end. Therefore, life on earth has a beginning and it has an end. The world was created at God's appointed time, and it will come to an end at God's appointed time. Therefore, as the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 3, talks about the human heart, God creating everything and putting in the heart of mankind, He has set eternity in the human heart. The human heart is able to accommodate all that God has put in eternity. But as Ecclesiastes says, He has set eternity in the human heart, yet no one can fathom what God has done from beginning to end, because people lack knowledge. They don't know God's word of truth. They don't know God's plan. Therefore, because they lack knowledge, they know nothing except the things of this world. So, as the preacher says, I have seen the burden God has laid on human race. He has made everything beautiful in its time. God has created all things, and he has also set eternity in the hearts of humankind, yet no one can fathom what God has done from beginning to end. For thus saith the high and lofty one who inhabits eternity, whose name is holy. I dwell in the high and holy place with him who has a contrite and humble spirit, to revive the spirit of the humble, and to revive the heart of the contrite ones. Isaiah says in the book of Isaiah, chapter 57, verse 15. The book of Acts, talking about the mankind should seek the Lord. Starting from verse 17, book of Acts, chapter 15, verses 17 and 18, so that the rest of mankind may seek the Lord, even all the Gentiles who are called by his name, says the Lord, who does all these things, known to God from among the Gentiles who are turning to God. Jesus Christ came and died for all humanity, that all may seek the Lord, and whoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. We're going to continue with the discussion, talking about eternity, how God created things within eternity, and also how God has laid a burden on the human race, how he has made everything beautiful in his time. He has set eternity in the human heart, and according to God's plan, God has a plan and purpose for everyone's life. It is our prayer that he may grant you according to your heart's desire and fulfill all your purpose. Stay blessed and shalom.